penalties against Phil Taylor. When he gets himself chances, he's got to take them. Because if Phil Taylor steps up with 75% of his form, you know the area where he's going to dominate. And that will be those checkouts around the 86, 92. Daryl will leave a double, Phil takes out 72. And you know what? That's what Phil Taylor built his reputation. That's why he won so many tournaments.
Not a bad start from the power.
I told you Daryl would get more run out of this.
There's time yet. He has become one of the biggest 180 hitters in world darts, Daryl Gurney. He's always had the ability to hit 180s, but over the last year, 18 months, he seems to have taken it to another level, Daryl Gurney. Shares the record for most amount of 180s hit in a Euro Tour game. That's just a first of six legs encounter. He hit nine in one match. Michael Smith, the joint holder of that record. Michael Smith managed to hit nine and lose his game.
Well, it's looking very focused, isn't it, Phil Taylor? Very focused indeed. And this start, especially against the throw, is exactly what he wants. He's going to get six darts from 1-2-1. Or should do. Now, I don't think Phil Taylor, if he hits the 51, I don't think he's going to go for the bull. I think big 18, that's typical Phil Taylor.
He's looked at Gurney's score, seen he's on a finish, and done that to make a point.
Absolutely. Absolutely. He said to Daryl Gurney, I don't think you're good enough to hit that at the moment. That's why I'm going big 18. Go on, have a go. Just a little... It is a little bit of gamesmanship, but it's a cracking 13 dart leg against the throw. There are a very, very odd time when you're going to get punished over that, but there are times that it
would. You'd be going apoplectic if he'd laid that up and Daryl took that 1-5-3.
Oh, yeah, of course he would. But he's playing a little game early on. He would not have done that at the back end, the business end of the game. That wouldn't have happened. But this early on, he's got time to get over it if Daryl takes out the 1-5-3.
So don't do that, say, in the last leg of a world championship. Nobody would do that, right?
Well, perhaps Eric might. Yeah, our friend Eric Bristow did it to Keith Miller in 83. And that backfired that time, but... 81.
Major winner yourself, Rod, when you were playing. The first one's got to be hard to win, but as we've seen from Peter Wright this year, it doesn't necessarily mean that loads more will follow. Does it get harder and harder or easier? Is it just...
No, it definitely gets easier. I mean, to be quite honest, in my day, there was only possibly eight players that were capable of winning majors. The rest, no offence to them, but they were great players, but... So when you get over the line, it is easier when you get in that position again. But in today's game, you know, you don't go to a tournament and think, well, I can ease into the game because the first round's going to be a lot easier. It doesn't happen nowadays. The first round, if you're not ready for it, you're on your way home. That's where the difference is. But certainly, to answer your question, once you've won that first major, you've got your first foot on the run of that ladder, and from there on in, it is a little bit easier.
Well, Phil Taylor goes into a 2-0 lead. Daryl Gurney having won his first major. He's still some way behind the 80 major titles that Phil Taylor has claimed in his career. But do you expect Gurney to go on and claim more?
Yes, I do. And we mentioned Peter Wright. I think Peter Wright, I've always said, as you know, we've commentated a lot on Peter Wright, I've always said that he was good enough to win a major and to win several. You know, obviously Michael van Gerwen and Gary Anderson can take their lion's share, but there's so many tournaments now that we call TV majors that you've got a far better chance of winning a major nowadays as back then. There was only three or four back then, so it was a bit thin on the ground.
Well, when you look at the floor events this year, the ones away from the TV cameras, at 22 players championship events and 15 different winners. Now, admittedly, not all of the big guys turn up to all of the tournaments, but it does highlight that there is strength in depth in darts nowadays, and Daryl Gurney fires in a 1-7-1, and he's a product of that system.
Well, it's proved that the system that's been brought in over the last years has proven to be right, and we change little bits each year, and people don't like some of the changes. Double 16 now for Daryl Gurney. All right, okay. A little bit of a mishap there from
just
us.
The 25 hit. Single 17 to leave tops and get Daryl Gurney on the board. Phil Taylor nowhere in this leg. 2-1.
Yeah, as I was saying then, you know, this assistants have been brought in, which are absolutely brilliant. When the 128 tour cards come in, and things are going to change on that next year with regard to what we're going to do. You know, they're all changing for the better of the game, as Phil Taylor hits his second maximum of the match. And it's breeding a better player. And that is proven on the tours. If you said 15 out of the 22 tour events, different players, 15 different players, that's incredible.
Well, it's only this year that Daryl Gurney picked up his first PDC title in that great cathedral of darts that is the Barnsley Metrodome. But then just his second title was one of the big ones at the World Grand Prix, very much like Mensur Suljovic, who won on the Euro Tour, and then his second title was the Champions League at that.
Well, the thing is with Phil Taylor, you know his action will not break down at any time. He never doubts the way his arm is going to work. And if he keeps the pressure on, then, you know, there's a learning curve all the time, and if you get behind against Phil Taylor, it takes a very strong-willed man to get back at him. He's 32 for a 3-1 lead, and he looks pretty. Oh, he's attacking the board, isn't he? Taking the game to Daryl Gurney.
3 out of 3 on the doubles for Phil Taylor, thrown with authority. 1 out of 1 for Gurney. But Taylor averaging 108 right now, and this is the highest quality stuff we've seen so far this weekend, just as he throws in a 45.
And we all know the one thing that Phil Taylor loves to do is put the youngsters in their place, the up and coming boys, and the old fellas still here. I understand that mentality, I have to say.
Yeah, Phil Taylor referring to Gurney as a little monster in his interview for this one. And he has loved over the years, Taylor, not just beating people, but absolutely pulverizing them. He is a darts player with very, very minuscule reserves of mercy for his opponents.
Well, there's no sympathy on that stage, Dan, as you know. No one's going to go, oh, I'll give you this leg, I'll give you that leg just to get you into it. No. You're going to get thrashed in the middle if you're out on your game. And Phil Taylor has made the perfect start. That could be very costly, that dart on the floor. Very costly indeed, because if Taylor hits a ton or a 140, it could be big pressure. Well, he'll get a ton from that dart, surely. Now he should get a 140 from the second one. There you go.
Well, Gurney, he's under 100, but he's going to have to use all three darts to see this off. Tops. Oh, that was the route. He couldn't take it out. And just that one bounce out, even if it was a big 20, has made a huge difference in this
leg. He would have given him one dart at a double game instead of setting it up. Now, Phil Taylor, we talked about this at the beginning of this match. They leave doubles, Phil Taylor takes it out.
He does take it out. 4 out of 4 on the doubles, 108 average, and even though Super Chin is... He's in this kind of mood, he can just throw like this all day, and that looked the most savage bounce out that I've seen all weekend there from Daryl Gurney.
Yes, it was very costly, because it would have given Daryl at least one dart at the double top. However, he only left the double top, but we did say at the top of the show before this match started, and the first opening conversation in here, Dan, that Phil Taylor, the best part of his game was when a player leaves the double, he takes out a 72. I think I said a 72 or 74. Okay, I was wrong. It was a 76 at a crucial time.
I'll give you
even I get little things wrong.
Oh, Phil. Taylor's turned to have one fall out the board.
Yes, but at a time when it's not going to punish him, not going to hurt him too much.
Now then, Daryl Gurney, 177. He's not hit a 180 yet, but he's had a 171 and a 177. Oh. What a leg of darts!
Superb leg of darts to open up leg six. Who can get home in six darts from here? Phil Taylor's going to get the first chance. And that last dart, you kind of knew that was going to happen the way it was. It was like a tray laying there. You just had to lob it on top of the darts. It was definitely going to hit the treble.
60. One treble gets Taylor a dart at a double. And he's not been missing doubles. And he continues not to miss another one of those awkward checkouts that Phil Taylor takes out. 5-1.
Well, there it is, 5 out of 5. You see 6 out of 6 last night in a race to 6 from James Wade. 5 of those on double top. Phil Taylor's been using quite a few different doubles, but the 76 and that 116, absolutely top notch. I mean, the 76 was when Daryl's on 40, 116 was when Daryl on 124. It's just real hurtful checkouts.
And Taylor's playing in that mode where you just think he's probably even oblivious to what his opponent's on. He's just in the zone. That's why he's averaging 111 right now.
Well, Daryl's not been in this position at all against Phil Taylor, but very often against other players where whatever he does, he's being beaten. You know, he's being beaten for 180s, which we didn't expect. He hits a 140, Phil Taylor returns and then takes a check out of him. There comes a point when it does start to wear you down. Well, double 8 will help him here.
122. First dart we've seen missed at a double in this game, but Daryl Gurney knows he's coming back. Phil Taylor, despite being the greatest dart player in history, did his level best not to leave a finish with that last visit. 268. Double 4. To cut the gap.
But Gurney's got to start getting these breaks to throw back down, and it's got to start right now. You cannot start letting Phil Taylor get to the business end of this game with 2-3 legs clear, because you know he's not going to let you off. So Gurney's got to look at minimum, or maximum I should say, 12 dart leg.
He's not done a great deal wrong, Daryl Gurney. I mean, he's still averaging 104, but Phil Taylor has just been excellent in the opening stage of this. Now only missing out the fourth 180. Super Chin still looking for his first, despite a couple of 170 plus scores. That looks in fighting though, doesn't it?
Yeah, he's got to find some 180s and he's got to find them against the throw. Taylor at the moment doesn't look like he's going to let up.
Taylor again finding a treble 20 with his last dart when he would have left a bogey number with a single 20. No finish for Gurney, and Taylor edges towards a 6-2 lead.
No intention of going for the treble 17 ball there again, although he did ask what was left. So 32 for a 13 dart leg with the throw. 4-6-2.
Oh, well, he's missed one. He doesn't miss another in Phil Taylor. Practically flawless finishing from the power. Daryl Gurney had never played Phil Taylor in a big stage game before. They'd only met twice. Once was the start of last year in a tour event. He was beaten 6-2. The other time, we've got to go back 7 years for their other meeting. It was in Killarney in Ireland, an event there, where he's beaten 4-1. So he's played twice. He's been given a couple of hidings. And at the minute, Phil Taylor is averaging 107 and hitting 86% of his darts at double against him. So the signs are we could see something similar here.
Yes, Gurney's just got her up it. With over 104 average sounds, incredible. If Taylor keeps playing the way he is, that 104 is not going to be enough. And Phil Taylor from here, if he's not that bothered if he doesn't win a leg against the throw, because he knows he's got so many chances of winning legs with the throw that's going to get him over the line.
That's it, the way he's throwing, Phil Taylor looks like he's going to be completing legs on his own throw in sub-15 darts, and that means that Gurney has to be throwing 12 darters to break him, and he's going to have to throw a few of them from this position. And that is a big ask. He's capable of it, but it is a big, big ask.
Yes, you're exactly right, Dan. I mean, Phil Taylor's average of just under the 105 is consistent across the board. It isn't, you know, up and down. It is the heartbeat. His heart rate is along the line. So, yes, Daryl Gurney's going to have to find a 12-darter to break Phil Taylor. And he's got to hold on to his throw with no more than 15 darts. Otherwise, he's going to go behind even further.
Double top, then.
26.
Once again, Taylor not on a finish, so Gurney will have another crack at it. I mean, I remember the last time that Phil Taylor won the Grand Slam, for example. I think he had a tournament average of 104. And it was pretty much 104 from the very first visit of the tournament until the very last one. It was just that constant Phil Taylor level that is just very, very difficult to overcome.
When you analyse Phil Taylor's throw down, I mean, you know, we talk a lot, Wayne Mardell and myself, about do not lose the height with the elbow, because that will make the dart go low. And if you look at Phil Taylor's action, the elbow stays in exactly the same place. He just brings the dart back just below the eye, and it's just a good solid release.
Well, part of the key in this performance from Taylor so far, and that doesn't really illustrate it, the first dart has been excellent. It's been right at the bottom of the treble 20 bed, and that's perfect for him to stack those darts on top. That one looked good, and then he's just skewed them off over to the left-hand side. But as a general rule, that's why he's hit 3 180s.
Yeah, that one's a bit low to be called a good guy, but he still found the treble from it.
You see the frustration there from Taylor, because he quite liked that second dart and he wasn't able to follow it into the treble bed. But he does have a decent lead in this leg. Just been eroded though, hasn't it? Entirely.
Well, I quite expect Phil Taylor to go 25 here. No, he's gone for 57. I did expect perhaps a 25 there, because obviously the 116 is a far easier checkout. And the 1-2-2, the 1-2-2 he has to finish on the bullseye going for 18. 16. However, Daryl Gurney again at a crucial time has not set it up.
Last leg before the break.
He's going 18 again.
Well.
I knew he was going to do that. The little teaser to set it up for the ball and going, oh no, I tell you what, yeah, look. See the little grin from Phil.
Well, he's got away with it again, Phil Taylor, but if he continues to play with fire, he may well get burnt.
He'll be required 32.
Double 16, he's only missed one dart at double in this match so far. And it is still only one dart missed. Phil Taylor, 103 average, a 7-3 lead.
Gurney, although he's on 100 average, he's not hit a 180 yet. And that is the crucial part of Daryl Gurney's game. If you don't hit 180s, and he's got to do it against the throat, you're not going to have enough power scoring to beat Phil Taylor as it is at the moment.
Well, he has hit a couple of 170 plus scores, and he's been pretty good at firing in the ton 40s, but it just has not been enough against Taylor in this kind of mood. Taylor last night, it might well have been enough, but last night was last night when he saw Robert Marjanovic, 6'2". It's kind of a rite of passage. If you want to be one of the greatest darts players in the world, you have to go and play Phil Taylor on a big stage, and him just putting a vintage power display and wipe the floor with you. So at least Gurney's getting this out of the way before Phil retires.
Well, at the moment, this is the performance of the tournament. And Phil Taylor carried it on at the match play. And he could easily carry it on here.
Good setup shot from Daryl Gurney. And of course, we did see Peter Wright come from an unlikely deficit to overhaul Mensur Suljovic. But this is Phil Taylor. Going to take out the 1-2-1. He is going to be sat very dangerously poised if Gurney doesn't hit the tops.
Pressure for you. Oh, that's a great last dart for Gurney. He's just kept him in the match as well. And Phil Taylor says, Drew, that's a good dart, which, yes, it was. Because at 8-3 down, you are, well, you're too far away to get it back. But Phil Taylor, all he just knows to hold on to his throw, and he's getting over the line in the semi-final against James Wade.
This Taylor is probably the best in the world at being able to praise his opponent and kind of have a sly dig at the same time. So, oh, well done, it's a really good shot that he's still 7-4 down. This is just a hint of condescension in there. Absolute master.
Yes, an absolute master, and he learnt from one of the best as well in Eric Bristow. Anyone who was brought up in Eric Bristow's era had to get used to being the gamesmanship. So you hardened to it. You actually learnt a few tricks yourself. Some of them are very subtle.
Some of them weren't so subtle, were they?
That happened now.
Like just flat out being kicked.
Deserved every kick.
Gurney just seems baffled by the fact that he hasn't been producing the 180s, because he does genuinely believe that he can hit maximums right up there with the likes of Chisnell and Anderson and Michael van Gerwen. And to be fair, over the last few months he's been proving that he can, but it's not happened for him here.
But he's got the perfect chance here now.
86.
Perfect chance. I mean, Phil Taylor, will he take out the 1-2-4? Well, he's going to have a dart at least at the bullseye. Double 11 it is. Now, there's the chance.
The first time in this game that Phil Taylor has had a visit and not seen off. Oh, Gurney needed the double-double. And that one miss from Taylor goes unpunished. Will he allow Gurney another chance in this one? He's not going to nestle alongside that one. But not there.
14.
But Gurney made the mistake, Dan, from 96. May only get one dart of the double. Oh, he's going to get two at 16s. Oh, break a throw back. A little light at the end of the tunnel. Oh, now he's just praising him up again.
Interesting times. He will take his time, Daryl Gurney. He will not be rushed. And he says, it helps him produce his best. And that's his first 180. And is this game changing?
Well, his first 180 with the throw has come at a great time. He's just broken the throw of Phil. So now put a real strong leg of darts in, and you're only one off. Just turn the concentration side of this game a little bit around.
When I ran out 40.
Strong leg from D. Gurney to cut the gap to just one. And it's been a game which Taylor has dominated and just been in cruise control. Just those little misses have allowed Gurney back into it. The pressure is on him now, though.
Yes, Gurney's previous three darts, failed the treble with the first dart, needed to find another treble. He's going to get two darts, a double 18 though. The last two legs have been clinical finishing from Daryl Gurney. And he is back in this match. And at one time, Dan, we thought that Taylor was going to run away.
It is very impressive how Super Chin has held his nerve and not panicked with the greatest player in history chucking the kitchen sink at him.
I think that's where Daryl Gurney has learnt over the last 18 months, that he doesn't give up now. He doesn't throw his dummy out the pram. He just keeps concentrating and getting on with the game. Certainly two, 3 years ago, this would have been over by now.
Düsseldorf crowd singing, walking in a Phil Taylor wonderland. We have heard this song sung at German darts venues for the last few years, even though Phil hasn't even graced them with his presence. I think all day. But what looked like a stroll, Phil Taylor, is turning into anything but.
But Phil, you know, Taylor has not altered his game. He's still up at 105, just over. So it is Gurney that's up in his game a little bit to, you know, put him in a position where he can see, at least see Phil Taylor's legs anyway.
Well, that's it. Taylor's just been, Gurney's been snapping at his heels, but just hasn't been able to chase him down because Taylor's been taking all of his chances in the early part of the game. And the one time he slips up, Gurney does step in. And it's just given him a little glimmer of hope, although he's not going to leave a finish here, even if he fills it up. Like one of those awkward finishes, isn't it? I'm talking about earlier on. This one's not going to go.
54.
Yes, he weren't going to do anything flash. Didn't hit that 54. Just set it up. Well, the Gurney will put a little bit of pressure on. But he hasn't missed his double 16 very often, Dan. And to go 8-6 up.
Another dart thrown with authority by Phil the Power Taylor. 8-6 up, two legs away. We've only got three quarterfinals for you this afternoon with the withdrawal of Michael van Gerwen. But my word, they have been belters, haven't they? Raymond van Barneveld 10-8 against Gary Anderson. The lead changing hands three times in that one. Peter Wright reeling off four consecutive legs to win 10-9 against Mensur Suljovic, surviving a match dart in the process. Daryl Gurney, averaging 99, keeping Phil Taylor honest in this one, but the power is putting in one of those vintage Phil Taylor displays at the moment.
Can't have too many visits without a treble. Still got a good lead, but only a handful of darts, so a real strong throw here from Taylor, which is not going to happen. So Gurney has seen a chance and in position to get back within one again for Taylor at 8-7.
Previous meetings, Daryl Gurney had only picked up three legs against Phil Taylor. He's already won twice that number. Not going to take out the 143. This is the bullseye, so it's a little bit more awkward than it might have been when he returns to the board. But he has, over the last three legs, made finishes like this look very straightforward. Took out 71, took out 87. Can he take out 63?
31. Daryl required 32. 15,
no problem at all. Daryl Gurney now just one leg behind again, but he needs to find a break of throw, and he needs to find it very, very soon.
Well, that's possibly the worst start we've seen Phil Taylor on his throw in the whole match. 45. A chance gone begging, Dan, isn't it? He knows it as well, the way he walked back.
1 goal.
Super Chin made it all the way to the final in his World Series debut in Las Vegas this summer. He has matured into one of the top darts players in the world right now, Daryl Gurney. He's going to continue his development. It's games like this where he needs to produce something special, and that is not very special. Not a bad recovery.
Not at all. I mean, I think he's won, what, somewhere in the region of 300,000 in the last year, 12 months. Daryl Gurney has on the tour. Proves how well he's been playing. Well, now 140 here, Dan, could really put the pressure on.
Well,
that gives him an outside chance now. What Daryl Gurney wants to see Phil Taylor is miss the 25 or ball together. Well, 17-4 double top.
42.
Just high, skewing just north of the wire. Huge moment this. Treble 14, just slips into the treble 11. It would have left the dart at double top.
69.
Taylor gave him the chance. Super Chin couldn't take it for 9-7. 9-7 it is. Gurney on the brink.
You know, I'm old school down with commentating an awful lot. You know, you practice on that treble 20, 90% of your scoring power time. And you're 101 and you go for 19s. You know, if you hit the 19 that leaves 82, are you going to go for bullseye, which is half the sign of treble 14? It just seems strange to me that some players on a crucial time like that, if I want to hit a treble, what is the easiest treble on the dartboard to hit? You've got to say treble 20, haven't you? Fair comment?
Well, I'm not going to disagree with the Prince of Style, Rob. Royalty.
That sounded right.
Oh, crams the last one in there. Taylor with a fifth 180, and maybe it can turn this leg his way and he can avoid the kind of problems Mentor Suljevic got into, but Gurney's not backing down. A second maximum for Super Chin. Oh, it's good, isn't it? Just the ton 40, but both on 81 after 9. Superb leg of darts this. Who can close it out? Has to be 12 for bullseye. Gets the treble, double 13.
68.
That could be that for Daryl Gurney. Misses double 13 for the 12 darter, and the power has the same equation, 81. They'll look at the 12s as well. Bullseye for the match.
48. Daryl, you require 13.
That's the easy bit done. Double two, pressure. And Taylor, 60% on his doubles, he's been deadly on double 16. A single one will leave it in for the match. That's what he's got. And that's what he hits. Bill Taylor, 100 average, 5 180s, and a 10-7 victory against Northern Ireland's number one. Taylor looking to bow out in style in professional darts in Germany. He's through to the semi-finals of the German Darts Masters, and he will take on James Wade tonight for a spot in the final. Could it be?